Hull surface is pitted with meteor scars. However, scanners make out a name. SS Botany Bay.
Then you can check the registry.
No such vessel listed. Records of that period are fragmentary, however. The mid-1990s was the era of your last so-called World War.
The Eugenics Wars.
Of course. Your attempt to improve the race through selective breeding.
Oh, now, wait a minute. Not our attempt, Mr. Spock. A group of ambitious scientists. I'm sure you know the type. Devoted to logic. Completely unemotional.
Doctor, I would be pleased.
All right, gentlemen, as you were.
That'll be all. You'll live.
My compliments.
Oh, no, I'm good, but not that good. There's something inside this man that refuses to accept death. Now, look at that. Even as he is now, his heart valve action is twice the power of yours and mine. Lung efficiency, 50% better.
An improved breed of human. That's what the eugenics war was all about.
I'd estimate he could lift us both with one arm. Be interesting to see if his brain matches his body.
This con is not what I expected of a 20th century man.
I note he's making considerable use of our technical library.
Common courtesy, Mr. Spock. He's going to spend the rest of his days in our time. It's only decent to help him catch up. Would you estimate him to be a product of selected breeding?
There is that possibility, Captain. His age would be correct. In 1993, a group of these young supermen did seize power simultaneously in over 40 nations.
Well, they were hardly supermen. They were aggressive, arrogant. They began to battle among themselves.
Because the scientists overlooked one fact. Superior ability breeds superior ambition.
Interesting, if true. They created a group of Alexanders, Napoleon.
I've collected some names and made some counts. By my estimate, there were some 80 or 90 of these young supermen unaccounted for when they were finally defeated.
That fact isn't in the history texts.
Would you reveal to war-weary populations that some 80 Napoleons might still be alive?